for bikers from India, there hasn't been a ride like this. Northeast is an amazing place, and I have been here many times.
I'm in the Guwahati Address Hotel, and welcome to Chennai, the Great Wanderer. Here we met a few people. They are doing a ride from India to London, and I'll just have a chat with them.
Hi people, I'm Kumarasan, they call me Rasan, and I'm from Coimbatore. I plan to buy an ADV bike just because I want to do long rides, and I have Viktorianz bike, sir, was one of the main reasons for me to take up these long rides. I'm doing this ride only because he called me. Okay. If it was for someone else, I would have backed out.
Okay.
And that's the truth.
Okay, yes, sir.
Because I have so much confidence in Viktorianz.
Okay.
That it'll be hassle-free. They'll keep me out of all troubles. So all I would do is just enjoy the scenery, ride, and have fun.
Okay.
People have asked me, like, you know, why have any, you know, theme or something like, you know, to go to London.
Okay.
Mine is, you know, to ride to London for no reason.
No reason, okay.
Yes. Why we need a reason to ride?
No,
riding itself gives happiness.
Yes, yes. It feels good, yeah. And peace of mind.
So that's the reason I've taken up, I ride for him. And why London? Because Manoj sir has planned it.
Okay.
I'm joining him.
Okay.
That's.
How does it start the whole plan? I mean, from riding from India to London is not a small thing, you know. I mean, lots of.
Yeah, actually, riding to London is. Can't tell, it's not easy.
Yes.
But with the roads and the bikes, the recent technology involved in all these things, I doubt it's going to be that hard when you compare to the previous time.
Okay.
And as a biker, if you ask anybody, they'll tell you, riding bike is more important than the destination.
Enjoying the moment.
Yeah, actually they have fixed it in London, but even if you have to make a U-turn at Paris also, it's going, doesn't going to make a difference with us.
Okay.
All we want to do is enjoy riding with good people. Actually, I prefer riding my bike as light as possible.
Okay.
But just because for this long ride,
I
was forced to put on additional weight. Like, you know, my bike didn't even have a center stand.
Okay.
For this purpose, I put a center stand now. I've added panniers. Then I have increased the engine protection base plate, made it thicker. I put on clear water lights.
Okay.
All these are add-ons. Actually, these things make it slightly difficult to ride the bike than riding very light. But still, you know, these are essentials. When you ride long, you need all this.
Okay.
You cannot avoid it.
First time in Assam or Northeastern part?
Sir, previously when I did a Bhutan ride with Viktorianz last year, we happened to come back from Bhutan via Assam.
Via Assam.
Yeah. My last destination during that ride was Assam.
And the Samlu Zonkar or Kelepu site?
I exactly don't remember that. But I remember the highway. A beautiful highway.
Okay.
I think during the whole Bhutan ride, the highest speed we touched on the bike was the highways in Assam only, because the whole Bhutan didn't have that good roads.
So the moment we
reached our India,
okay,
and entering Assam was our biggest, doing the max speeds.
I would love to ride northeast because it's got most, hilly area, and it's got a wonderful climate.
Meghalaya, you can.
So we like to definitely explore it, but we just have to find time with my Manoj sir. So I must ask him when he's going to take us next.
Okay.
So if he does give us a green signal, maybe we'll come next year. Sure. Definitely.
So this is your wall ride, kind of wall ride. This is the first wall ride, or this you have done?
For bikers from India, there hasn't been a ride like this.
Okay.
Organized. I mean, people have done solo.
Solo, yes.
Or in pairs.
Yes.
You know, they have done on their own steam.
Okay.
But this is the first organized ride, and from Viktorianz also, this is the first ride we are launching.
Correct.
So we want to do one iconic ride a year, and we have some very solid riders on our ride. You know, some people we knew in terms of attitude,
in terms
of positivity, in terms of riding skills.
So
some very close friends of ours who have been with us are riding on this ride. So we were fortunate that our first launch ride is with a very hardcore group of riders. Okay, so so Viktorianz's purpose is to ride the world on a motorcycle or a car. I mean, it's a road trip. We want to ride the world meter by meter, not just flying into a place, staying in some hotels and coming back. So we want to go and ride the world meter by meter, interact with locals, go to unknown places, go slightly unscheduled. Of course, there is a schedule, but in the day you are pretty free to interact with anything, watch the vistas which you want to stop. So aim is to explore the world, meter by meter. And it's our dream to, you know, bring in destinations around the world where people can ride and travel. So that's the purpose. Otherwise, for this ride, we have a theme called The World is One Family. You know, basically, a whole world should get together to solve the problems of the world.
This is
Prime Minister's on Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, which means the world is one family, and we must solve the problems of the world as a common, united people. Yeah, that's the aim.
So, Manu sir, can you tell us about the notice? What do you feel about the notice? I mean, it's kind of different to the mainstream land of India.
Yeah.
Like it's like green, and the culture is different. How do you find it? It's your first time in the notice, or you have been to earlier in Northeast? Like, what do you feel about the northeastern part of India?
So Northeast is an amazing place, and I have been here many times. From my early age of 21 years, it was my first visit to parts of Silchar and Tinsukia. I have been there. And we've done a lot of Northeast. We do Sikkim a lot, we do Bhutan a lot, we do Assam a lot, been to Silchar, been to Manipur earlier, been to Hornbill, right?
Hornbill,
yes. So we do a lot of Northeast, and we're fond of Northeast. The fortunate part is the roads are opening up to Southeast Asia. And the launch pad for all those road trips has to be Northeast. And my opinion, Guwahati, Imphal, Kohima, of course, it's a very solid thing. Is sitting at a launch pad for all the excursions which can go into Southeast Asia.
Yes.
And now it's a launch pad for even an excursion up to Europe. So
This is the only road, by road you can go only this part.
And the Asian highway which is now coming up, it's going to open up a lot of this stuff.
Okay.
So we're looking forward to that. We're also looking forward to Northeast, some of the Second World War battles. So there's 75 years of Battle of Kohima and Battle of Imphal. So we're looking at a ride which starts from Singapore and finishes in Kohima. You know, seeing through the various battles which happened in Mandalay and Irrawaddy, and Battle of Imphal, Battle of Kohima.
Yes.
Looking forward to doing something like that.
So in future, you are planning to organize any ride? I mean, to explore the east, northeastern part of the states. I mean, like in Meghalaya, Manipur, and
we have a couple of rides. Yeah. Hornbill ride, as I told you, is our annual ride.
Annually, we
do Hornbill.
Okay.
And this covers Kaziranga, Majuli, Mukokchung, does Kohima, does Imphal. Does Silchar, gets back
to
Meghalaya, and we do various parts of Meghalaya before we finish the ride in Guwahati. So we already have a ride like that, but we really want to do Arunachal, Lakhimpur, and the northern Bomdila. You know, there is always a thing like you make it too popular and too many people come and spoil
it. That's
so, you know, I feel that Northeast is very unique and must remain unique in its way. There are lots of locations like in North Thailand and all, the places have grown very popular without really exploiting them. You know, that means the benefits of the tourism should go to locals.
Correct.
So that they preserve those places. The problem is that the big fish wants to take in too much of commercialization and want to do lots of numbers. And these unique lands continue to go away, like unique species go away.
Yes, yes.
Similarly, unique lands also go away by over-exploitation. So, you know, a live example is like Ladakh.
Yes, it's
which
like
has been spoiled so badly.
Yes.
Similarly, you have Chadar Trek, you know, which has been spoiled so badly by over-numbers, commercialization.
Yes.
You know, so my worry is that. So this ride is not just ride. It's
correct.
It's a lot of exploration of local places. See important places on the way, like from Imphal. And when we're going to Imphal on after Dimapur, we will go to that cemetery in Kohima,
correct.
Second World War.
Okay.
You know, where soldiers of the age of 16 and 17 laid down their lives in Second World War. So yeah, we're doing a lot of experiential riding, exploratory riding. That's the plan. Yeah, Lalit, so thanks a lot for coming around and talking.
Okay.
And yeah, we are ponderers. So I think
it's
a good thing for your great ponderer YouTube thing.
Thank you, sir.
So wish you all the best, and I'm sure lots of people in future will have this vision and dream to explore the world.
Yeah.
I think that's what we came in this world for, to explore.
Okay, thanks. So thanks a lot, sir.
Thanks, Lalit. Thanks a lot for coming by. Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you.
It's India to London, right? And this is organized by Viktorianz World. It's like, I'll show you the map of their route. This is Viktorianz.com, and this is a map of their route. Six motorcycles and two vehicle and four wheeler for this ride. Also, my bike one have parked in the Guwahati address hotel.